Today is Saturday, November 25th, 2023. This has been a train wreck of a morning in many ways. I got out here at about legal shooting time where it's light enough to see. And my plan was to set up in the woods and just kind of see if I can catch some deer cruising through there. And I got to where I walked in the woods where I didn't expect there to be any deer, and I was gonna walk to where I could pop over this ridge and look down a valley where I expected them to travel. And I took 5 steps in the woods and a deer took off running and blowing. I thought I couldn't get away with it, so scratched that plan. Just came back and got in this stand. And whenever I got to the stand, I looked down this lane that it overlooks, and there's a deer out there. It ran off. And then I start climbing up here, get halfway up the ladder, and I look back, and there's another deer that came out of the lane that was just looking at me. And I thought, this is terrible. So it trotted off. I don't know that it saw me or if it just ran off because the other deer did. I thought, it's terrible. Then I sat for a while and looked out in this neighbor's field. I think a deer club leases that, but nobody ever hunts the field. I think the deer know that. They cross there a lot. But I was just kind of glancing out there, and I saw 6 deer in a line. They were all does. 2 of them were by themselves, and they kind of went across. And then there was 4 more that I think, that's the deer that I usually see around here. And 2 of the yearlings broke off, and they walked right up here 10 yards in front of me and came to this feeder to feed. But the big mama does would never get close. They kind of hung back. They would never cross this little bridge that the construction company made. So I kind of watched them. The little ones fed around by the feeder. The big ones hung back, and the big does finally just went back to some brush. And then it was funny, the yearlings came back around, and they got to where they could see down this gas line. And when they could see down there, the first 2 does that were in front of their group came back, and they thought it was their, I guess, the mama does. So they went trotting up to them, and once they got up to them, they quickly found out that wasn't the does they were looking for. So that was fun getting to watch them walk around like that. And I think they finally made it back where their mama does were. And then about written off the rest of the day. Then I look up and got 2 does that come out of here, the feeder. And the way they were acting, I don't think that they're regulars around here, because that big one was really spooked by the feeder. And so she kind of was about to bolt. And we need some deer meat. And so I shot her. She went maybe 20 yards and fell over. So just later in the morning, figured the deer probably gonna bed up for the day, and so I thought might as well shoot one while, you know, it's not gonna hurt too much. That way I can drive right up here to that lane and just drag her right out and get her and load her up in the truck.
Here she is, a big old doe. I'm just so excited about this. So grateful that the Lord blessed me with a deer today. Been seeing plenty out here, but just waiting on the big buck. Just watching so many deer that I realized it wouldn't hurt to take out a couple of does this year. And so everything came together today. She wasn't one of the regulars. She seemed to be pretty nervous walking through this spot. And so got her, still saw the regulars after she came out. And so they're still around. And so still got some good decoys for the big guy that's out here. So I'm going to get her home, get her processed up, and we'll be back out here again sometime. Probably take a break for a little bit and just kind of watch the cameras and see if we can't get this big guy on a pattern with food going into this late season. Still got plenty of time to hunt. And we got a good bow stand here too that may be the ticket for late season hunting over here. But it's crazy. Morning started out terrible and I thought it was just gonna be a wash, just a waste. But stick with it and spend time out in the woods. And you just never know what's gonna happen whenever you head out to have another Arkansas adventure.